It's very important to do an extended RAS assay, or what we call also all RAS assay. We know that about 40% of patients with metastatic colorectal cancer have a KRAS mutation. But about 10% of patients also have other mutations. These mutations could be either KRAS mutation, non-exon 2 mutations, such as exon 3 and exon 4, or NRAS mutations. And those patients will not respond to anti-EGFR therapy. And therefore, we do not want to subject them to anti-EGFR treatment, which will not result in any benefit, but may result in increased toxicity. So it is very imperative that any medical oncologist would test for extended RAS mutation assays at the time of a presentation of a patient with metastatic colon cancer. We do it when a patient presents for first-line treatment. It affects our decision-making. If a patient has a non-exon 2 KRAS mutation or NRAS mutation, those patients will not be considered for first-line anti-EGFR therapy and will not be considered for any anti-EGFR therapy in the paradigm of treatment in that patient. So how do we decide on the management of a patient with metastatic colorectal cancer? I think it's imperative that we take into consideration the age of the patient, the performance status of the patient, the pattern of metastatic disease, as well as the molecular profile of the tumor. And based on these considerations, I have to decide, is the patient potentially curable or not curable? And if the patient will benefit from targeted therapies, which particular targeted therapies? I think one essential test that has to be done in every patient with metastatic colorectal cancer is RAS mutation assay. Another test that I think is very important to obtain is BRAF mutation. And that has not actually been done consistently at this point in the community. Patients with KRAS mutation or NRAS mutation, exon 2, 3, or 4, will not benefit, as we stated earlier, to any anti-EGFR therapy treatment. But it's also important to realize that patients with BRAF mutation have a very poor prognosis, and those patients may benefit from more aggressive chemotherapy and may have less benefit from any anti-EGFR therapy as well. After we define the RAS status and the BRAF status of a patient, we have to consider what is the goal in the management of a patient with metastatic disease. Is the goal palliative with improvement in overall survival, or is there a chance towards a cure? Is the disease limited to the liver? Is there a potential for liver resection down the line or not? In patients where I consider that there is a chance with major downstaging that we will get to a liver resection for a cure or for a potential cure, those patients need to start with an aggressive chemotherapy regimen, because what we have to shoot for is the best response rate possible. And that's where I have to decide if I need to implement anti-EGFR treatments or if I need to use triplet chemotherapy regimens such as FOLFOXIRI.